This is an English guide to learning Swedish. This is by far the most difficult episode so far, not just for you, but for me as well. My mic is okay, but it's not great. I'm not sure how easy it will be to hear the difference between the sh sounds and the sh sounds. It might very well only sound like noise, and I'm afraid my audio editing will remove or distort the sound. I'm just saying this so that you don't think you're retarded, because you might not be able to proper hear the difference. In the Swedish language, there are two profound sounds that are not represented by a letter. These are the sh sounds and the sh sounds. I say them again. Sh and sh. In this episode, I only talk about the first type, the kh words. It would be very convenient if the kh sounds always was spelled the same, but that's not the case. To add to this, sometimes a kh sound is spelled as a sh sound and vice versa, and sometimes it's neither. I will list the letters composing the kh sound, ch, and then take a few examples on each version. Chock, choklad, cheddar. Again, there's a homophone hiding here. Try to find it. And as practice, listen for the short and long vowel. G-E. Generös. Generad. And the extremely retarded word, genre. G-I. Giraff. Religiös. S-C-H. Schema. S-I. Version. Fusion. Passion. S-J. Själ. Sjö. Sjuk. Hescha. Sjal. S-K. Skära. Själ. Skinka. Sked. S-K-J. Skjorta. Skjuta. Skjul. S-T-J. Stjärna. Själ. Stjärt. T-I. Station. Situation. Pretentiös. And that's about it. In the next episode, I will link some good links to practice this. Next time, I'll cover the similar sh sounds, and also briefly what I call the sh sounds, which sounds very similar. Thank you for watching.